They say that those who are good at languages are often good at music. Thomas, or Thom Lanning Moore, who wrote Cavan Girl, was not only good at languages, but he also understood the nuances of Irish melody and song. Born on the 6th of December, 1943, on the island of Santa Catalina, off the coast of Los Angeles. When aged 7, Thom's parents moved to Ethiopia, where, over a space of 3 years, young Thom Moore was exposed to the Russian language, of which he acquired a working knowledge. After returning to the US, he joined the Navy in 1961 and worked for a while as a journalist in Vietnam. Leaving the Navy life behind, in 1965, he studied Russian at the University of California. He eventually graduated with an MA in Slavonic Languages and Literature. Thom was introduced to Irish music by way of the Clancy Brothers and Tommy Makem, who he saw performing on US television just before he joined the Navy. Intent on seeking a more peaceful way of life, in 1971, Thom left America and moved to Ireland, his wife and child in tow. The family set up home in a cottage on the slopes of Knocknaree in County Sligo, and it was from there that Thom Moore immersed himself in Irish music. He befriended a host of local musicians, many of whom would gather for sessions at Colera House in Knocknahore, or at McGlynn's in Old Market Street in Sligo Town, or at Hennigan's in Wine Street. Teaming up with another two Americans, Rick Epping and Sandy Miller, in 1973, Thom and wife Kathy formed Pumpkinhead, an accomplished folk band whose music captivated Irish audiences. Pumpkinhead split in 1976, the Eppings and Moores deciding to pursue separate musical careers. Moore formed another group, Midnight Well, with Jane Cribbs on vocals, Marcin O'Connor on accordion, and Jerry O'Byrne on guitar. Like the proverbial duck to water, Thom took to songwriting, composing hits such as The Scholar, or The Train to Sligo, Carolina Rua, and Saw You Running. In February 1979, he entered the Cavan International Song Contest with his own ballad, Cavan Girl, which was duly awarded first prize. And, using part of his £1,000 winnings, he released it as a single. His inspiration for the ballad came from listening to the real-life story of Killeshandra man Michael Woods and Belturbet girl Rita Mundy, both of whom met in New York in the 1960s. Michael and Rita subsequently married and opened Colera House in Knocknahore. And it was there, said the Anglo-Celt, that the song Cavan Girl was penned. Featuring a well-crafted and memorable melody, the ballad was taken to new heights by Paddy Riley, who recorded it with the Dubliners. In the 1980s, when Mikhail Gorbachev and Ronald Reagan decided to limit their country's stockpile of nuclear weapons, Thom Moore's linguistic skills were put to good use. He was tasked with acting as an interpreter for Soviet weapons inspectors in Northern California, and fulfilled the same role for the Americans in the industrial town of Votkinsk in Russia. It was while in Votkinsk that Thom, then separated from his first wife, fell in love with Lyubov Korolyova, the couple subsequently marrying and moving to Ireland. After teaching for a while overseas, Thom returned to Ireland again, and in the 1990s he played a series of intimate concerts at venues such as the Corn Mill Theatre in Carrigallen, County Leitrim, the venue in Strand Hill, Sligo, and the Harp Tavern, also in Sligo. In 2006, he and the other members of Midnight Well reunited, but the venture was short-lived. As for Cavan Girl, it was translated into French by Renaud Séchard, a seasoned singer from Paris. Those who knew Thom Moore remembered him as a multi-talented individual, as a man blessed with a roguish sense of humour. Thomas Lunning Moore died on St. Patrick's Day, 2018, his ashes scattered by his stepson, Stan, on the slopes of his beloved Knocknaree. And so ends the story of Thom Moore and his sublime ballad, Cavan Girl. As I walk the road from Killeshandra, weary I sit down, for it's 12 long miles around the lake to get to Cavan Town. The water and the road I go once seemed beyond compare. Now I curse the time it takes to reach my Cavan Girl so fair. Now autumn shades are on the leaves, the trees will soon be bare. Each red gold leaf around me seems the colour of her hair. My gaze retreats to find my feet, and once again I sigh for the broken pools of sky remind the colour of her eyes. At the Cavan Cross each Sunday morning, there she can be found, and she seems to have the eye of every boy in Cavan Town. If my luck will hold, I'll have the golden summer of her smile, and to break the hearts of cabin men she'll talk to me a while. So Sunday evening finds me homeward, Killeshandra bound, to work the week till I return and court in Cavan Town. When asked if she would be my wife, at least she'd not say no. So next Sunday morning, rouse myself, and back to her I'll go.